Hello and welcome back to another Future Doghouse production. As always, I read your comments and you have been asking for Favipiravir. Alright, is Favipiravir a cure, a possible cure or a treatment agent for COVID-19, the coronavirus? Let's find out, shall we? This Favipiravir medicine is also known as T705, kind of like Terminator 1000, except it's only 705, and Avigan and Favipiravir. Anyways, these are also its known names. Pyrazine carboxamide, why do we care about that? Well, this is the prodrug for this, so this came from this, but this also is the prodrug of pyrazinamide. And pyrazinamide comes from pyrazine carboxamide. And we are familiar with pyrazinamide because it in combination with rifampicin, isoniazid, and either streptomycin or ethambutol is the treatment for tuberculosis. That's how we know pyrazinamide. It's part of the treatment for tuberculosis. Now, the mechanism of action, here's how this medicine works. Possibly inhibits viral RNA-dependent RNA polymerase. Oh my God, that's a mouthful. What is a viral RNA-dependent RNA polymerase? Well, it's the virus, in order to create the RNA, needs an RNA polymerase to create this RNA so that it can replicate, especially RNA viruses. Here's the thing. If there is no RNA polymerase, if there's no RNA polymerase, there is no RNA being created, and thus there's no virus replication. That's how this medicine works. It also possibly induces lethal RNA transversion mutation. So again, if you make, say, a RNA that is not healthy, that's not conducive to making multiple viruses, then if you have a bad RNA, there's no virus replication. So that also may be how this medicine works. Here's a kicker. Yes, in China claims that they were successful in using this medication for or against COVID-19. But here's the thing. It's not effective in primary human airway cells. So if it's not effective, if this can't happen within the airway cells of the humans, of us, how effective is it against, say, influenza or COVID-19? So hence the big question mark. Now, I could be wrong. Not enough research has been done on this favipiravir. It's a fairly new medicine. So hope that explains to you if this is possibly a cure for COVID-19. If you like this video and you want more of these videos, please click subscribe. Thank you, and have a nice day.
She is a good student, but instead of just reading textbooks late into the night, Jennifer uses technology to help her study. She also watches lectures on YouTube and practices her knowledge with QUPI, a medical quiz app and online platform. Jennifer likes QUPI because it has 10,000 practice questions covering her entire medical course. This means she can practice her medical knowledge from anywhere and in a way that actually prepares her for the exams. Begin your 7-day free trial with QUPI today.